I'ma flex on my ex, flex on a hoe. You still be in my head, so I'ma let you know. I realize how much I want you when I...
What's going on, everybody? On today's episode, we are going to be doing a player review for the Flashback Juan Mata. It's been a while since we've had a Flashback card that's usable. I mean, we had that Mascherano a little bit during the Scream promo, but now we finally have a solid Premier League cam. We had Theo Walcott, Lucas Piszczek, Mascherano, and now we get Juan Mata. This card looks amazing. Right off the bat, you just take a look at that dribbling, 84 agility, 95 balance, 91 reactions, 92 ball control right off the start. His long shots are only 77, and his finishing's 82, which those are the concerning parts. You do get a Prime Electrum Players Pack and a Rare Electrum Players Pack. Ideally, you'd like a walkout or a board out of these SBCs, considering that they're at least 130k to complete. So when you spend 130k, you'd at least like to get something back. Unfortunately, out of both of our packs, we don't really get anything, but I am just going to show you guys what I got in case you're interested in completing this SBC for yourself. I was going to put this at the end, but I forgot to, so whoops. The squad we use him in, I forgot to show it, but it is a 4-2-3-1. So we have Wijnaldum and Lo Celso as our CDMs. We have Gomez and... I think it's Gomez and I don't even know who else at center back. Roberto Carlos at left back. Zaha at striker. And Walcott out wide with Pulisic out wide. They're just players I had in my club. Doesn't really matter. It's not about him. So let's get into the card. What did I notice? So in the first few games, I noticed that his finesse shots inside the box were really weak. They'd be placed well, but they wouldn't find the back of the net because they'd be so soft that the keepers would have no problem saving them, which was really kind of shocking to me. So after a few games, well, I originally started him with a Maestro chem style, but once I realized that wasn't gonna work, I switched him to a Deadeye chem style to boost the shooting. His long shots are much better now. His inside the box shooting is much better. His shot power is much better. His dribbling you don't really notice because it was already so high, but he's just such a fun card to use. I would highly recommend him to anyone who is looking to complete him. If he fits your team, if he doesn't fit your team, I would recommend him. He is an insane player. Definitely a boss in the midfield. As you can see by some of these clips, just the way that he carries the ball in the midfield and somehow manages to squeeze between two defenders that you would never expect. Right here, this is a great little opportunity. That's what I mean. That was before I switched the chem style. That was just a really soft shot. He does have really good free kicks. I managed to bang this free kick before the glitch. Before the glitch, wasn't placed that well, but it still went in. He's such a fun card. He finds space that no one else would find. He's able to beat players or squeeze through tight areas that no other player should be able to get through. I don't get it. He cuts through two players like it's nothing. His passes are perfectly weighted. His finishing, like that shot into the top bins, is just insane. He's just so consistent with that left foot shot. And truthfully, I thought he was right-footed for the first like two games I played. That pass there to Pulisic was insane. Once I finally realized that he was left-footed and I started putting him on his left foot, I realized what I was missing and how good he actually was as a player. I am so grateful I completed this card. I did have Bobby Firmino and Eriksen in place before him, so I'm glad that I now have this cool card to use instead. I feel like Flashback cards and special cards have like play above. This pass right here is insane. They definitely play above their level, if that makes sense. Like, he's an 87, but I feel like he plays way higher than an 87. Might just be for me, but his dribbling is insane. The little ball rolls, the scoop turns, like right there, that's just insane. What a great weighted pass to Zaha. Probably should have tried to cut that in and finesse it instead, but it wasn't too bad at all. Right here off the post, a little unlucky. But all in all, for 120-130k, this card is absolutely insane. I would 100% recommend it to anyone who is interested. These little through ball passes, like, so consistent. The little left foot, right foot dribbling, the the ball, like, the through balls are so good. He's just got such control. He can break through, like, right here. Like, how does he find that space to finish that shot? I have absolutely no idea. With the dead eye, I think that is the Kemp style you want, because his pace is already good enough. His passing and dribbling are already good enough. You just really want to boost that shooting, because I like my Kemp to score. No stats really concern me at all. This card just looks completely solid. Really fun card. I'm glad that EA are getting back to it now that all the promo's over. He just scores goals. I think in the first eight, I used him for 5 games, and he had 8 goals and 5 assists in 5 games. For 130k, you're not gonna get anything better than this. I mean, if he were on the market, he'd be about 50k. But you get the packs back and everything like that, and he's a really cool card. I really think it's worth it, and I would 100% recommend you guys go out and get that. If you guys enjoyed, please do leave a like, comment, let me know what you guys want to see. If you guys like these player reviews, let me know if there's anything I can do to make them better. Also, let me know. And once again, thank you all for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next episode.